You have your own contract?
Yes.
So we're back at it again, but good win last night for us, and now go up to East Lansing, play a team at Michigan State that is always tough. They're always well prepared. They're so well coached. They have such good players, and I think you've seen them at times like us play so well. And then there's times you see that they have some, that the injuries have been costly to them, just like the injuries to Indiana was last night. And you know, they'll show that sometime. A lot of young guys are going to be terrific. They also have their moments. Nobody knows that more than us, and what we've seen in the last couple of years with injuries and young kids. So it's gonna, hopefully it's a great game. Hopefully we can hang in there with them the whole game and win it down the stretch.
Brandon?
Hey, Coach. Last night you were kind of talking about the evolution of Mo and DJ and, you know, where they are right now. Games like last night can kind of be the pinnacle of what they can be. Where do you kind of go from now with that evolution? Like, what's really the next step with those two?
I think they're just experiencing right now what it's like to try to be a consistent player. You know, try to be every game, try to be, I know they're prepared every game, but the grind, handling the grind. You know, I still remember Nick Stauskas at Thanksgiving when we won the NIT his freshman year, and he wanted to be an NBA player. It was after Thanksgiving. He said, man, college basketball is a grind. It was Thanksgiving. So they're going through this experience where all of a sudden it was like, it was some great moments at this game, and now that moment's done. Now we're moving on, and you're going into to Michigan State territory. Getting back up for that challenge mentally and physically, that's the next step for all those guys to do it consistently like the great players do.
Brennan?
John, what needs to happen for this team to win on the road?
Oh, you know, we've been close at Iowa. I'm thinking about, but South Carolina was not close. Where was our other game?
UCLA,
you know, we were right there with them. So it hasn't, I don't think we've gone on the road and all of a sudden we're out of the game in the first minutes of any of those games, with the exception maybe of South Carolina. So we are, got to be able to really compete down the stretch, stay focused down the stretch, and get lucky down the stretch. Because once some of those things come together, right, all of a sudden, you know, then it's, oh man, we're a great road team. So hard to win on the road, you guys all know that, but it is you need a lot of, you need some good fortune as well. You can't always make all your breaks, but you got to try to.
And how, in a game like this, can your experience versus, you know, a team starting four freshmen, how can you use that to your advantage?
Well, I hope that we've been there before. You know, we had some really, I thought were impressive road wins last year, and so it is a... It's really important. Our kids can draw on some of that experience. But you look at Michigan State, they're given their schedule this year. They've played some really good teams, and they've been to war a lot of times too. So as I said, it may not come back to all of a sudden, oh boy, they were more experienced or they're well drilled in that. It could be a simple block charge call or a ball goes through or a ball go in and out that determines the difference in games like this. It appears that we're very evenly matched right now in many areas.
Or,
has it been determined yet who Muhammad's going to draw on defense, Bridges or Harris?
We'll talk about it. As a staff, we've done that, but I don't want anybody else to know that. So the team with him, and we'll do, you know, they'll switch some screens, we'll switch some screens. We'll see what happens and how the game evolves.
Chris?
You talk about Bridges a little bit and what you've seen from him.
I mean, and just watching him, I just watched the video of their last couple of games, but just watching his evolution now, I mean, he is a guy that has become a great three-point shooter. And I would think anybody that saw him as a high schooler or a summertime player would see this great athlete that could make plays and rebound and run and pass. And now you're seeing a kid that's added this 40% shooting. So... He's a very, very talented player. He's a really good kid, and you know, this is all sort of coming together for him right now. And, you know, over this year that his game is evolving, and he's got a great coach up there to sort of try and teach him along the way about, all right, this maybe you're overdoing this area, you got to do more of this area. for us to win and for you to grow your game. But really talented. I just think his athleticism and his ability to get rebounds. You'll see dunks and all that stuff. That's 2 points here, 2 points there. It's the traffic rebounds that he's going to get that you say, how did he get there and get it there? More impressive to me.
You've kind of dealt with, you know, in your time here, a lot of things changing in college basketball, one and dones, guys leaving early, NBA, constantly, you know, changing every single year. How different, how challenging is it, you know, when you look at Michigan State and Tom Izzo on a coach, when every single year you can't just depend on juniors and seniors, you do have freshmen, but then some years you do have a veteran unit. How do you go about maybe finding a way to get to that specific team?
Yeah, it's an interesting point because I think this, I don't know if you've got to go back a long time to when did the two of us play where we didn't have key people injured? You're going to have to go back 5 years, and here you got two really good programs, and we've always had these injuries going back and forth. And so you add that to it with you think this kid is going to come back and this kid's going to come back or they're not going to transfer you to do it. It is not an easy job to keep a program at the top all the time. 14 other teams are trying to do the same thing. We all have the same resources. You know, we all have that same emphasis on men's basketball. The Big Ten Network has been so good to us, to the whole conference financially, that we all competing. And it's with 14 teams doing it, it's difficult. But with the teams that have had great, incredible continuity, Wisconsin's a great example. The change is only, you know, over a 4-year period. There's change in guys. Those are the few that have not had these cycles that I think most of basketball goes through right now.
Noah,
John, you mentioned DJ and Mo in particular. I guess didn't play much against these guys last year. How eager are you to see how they handle, you know, what Michigan State brings in the front court?
You have to be able to handle at this level the Big Ten crowds, and that's the biggest thing. And this one's one of the better crowds, road crowds that we'll go to see. So that's the big thing. They got to go out there. I mean, we went up there with a team 1-6-1, and we went up there with a national championship type of team that Mitch McGarry threw the ball to them his first 3 times he had it, and they were out on us big with Trey Burke and everybody, right? So we have, you don't know how they're going to react, and hopefully we've had enough experience with our four or five road games that we can, all right, just stay in there. If you remember 2 years ago, we went up there with a team that had lost everybody, Derek and Karras, and it was an overtime game. That team really showed great substance when they had to do it.
Is that another question about Mo and DJ? Are they prepared to handle the minute loads that they're working with right now? I guess especially DJ. You know,
it's a concern only because DJ's, when we monitor to his movement, that he is exuding more than anybody else right now. And it's him and Derek are right at the top. And it's a quick twitch thing. It's a very active. He's trying to help everybody on the court. So we have to watch for that. See, he's never done that. We'll do very, with regard to that, like today's practice for them, we'll walk and we'll talk with them while we work at the other guys. But no, his numbers right now for his minutes is just spiked right now. And we do have to be careful. But every time, some guys are like that. You know, it's very hard for some guys to play, for Zach Novak to go out there and give you 38 minutes. His body had to work harder probably than others, right? Zach, DJ is so fluid. He doesn't probably burn as many calories. He doesn't take as much energy, so he's able to do it.
And then is that, I guess, for trying to keep him going the rest of the season, is it more resting him in practice like you do with Zach and Derek, or is it asking more out of dunking?
On select days. No, I think you've seen him right now. He plays defense, and he continues to make plays on offense like he did yesterday. He's a 35 to 32 minute guy, and that's the way he'll stay all year. And we just rotate Duncan at a couple spots so to make sure he can get his 20 to 30, and it all works out.
Brendan?
You've made the point so many times about, you know, every game is the same. You know, you want to have that kind of same mindset. Nothing's bigger than the next one. Things like that. It has seemed in some years that Michigan State has had a little bit more ill will and animosity going into this game that has been difficult for you guys to match at times. Do you think that that's the case? And is this a year that you could match that kind of level of
of play?
Yeah, I can't speak for them. I know the last couple of years that we have played them, we had some success a few years ago. They had injured guys, we won. We had injured guys, they won. And it comes down to a lot of that right now when you're trying to match. We lost guys to the pros, they won. They've lost a guy to the pros early, you know, that you don't think is going to lose. It's difficult. It's difficult to manage this. So I'm not going to speak about animosity. I'm saying we're going in this game. It's a great, great game every year, and now we play two of them, so it makes it even better. And I'm sure both teams will have the same type of desire to win this game. The animosity, I can't measure that, and I don't. I just want to go in and play this game the best we can play.
Kevin? Coach, after seeing Mo and DJ kind of get a chance to match up with guys like Bryant, Hap, Hayes, how comfortable are you with where they are with low post defense?
Well, I think it's growing every day. You'll see our man Mo will just give a layup up sometime because he'll go for something he can't possibly get. But he's getting educated every day on that. Marcus guarded all these type of guys. I mean, it's like he's guarding Derek Nix again. Right when he's playing against Ward, so it's that same low post presence, and this Ward kid is really gonna, you know, everybody's made about the other guys. This kid's their second leading scorer. He's getting the foul line a ton. He's taking the other guy out of the game with fouls. So we're getting better at it. Everyone's a new challenge. Some guys you don't have to guard. Some guys are right handed. Some guys are left handed. Some guys are dribble guys. Some guys are, they're gonna play off their jump shot. They're learning every day. I'm not comfortable, you know. I think the pro guys sure aren't comfortable with guys that they're always going to be great in the post. You just got to keep coaching and hope they get that, they meet the challenge of good positioning, good physical contact without fouling, and they embrace the challenge of being a better player.
Mark,
there's so much consistency when you have a guy like Tom who's been there every year. He plays the same way, same style, and everything. Mm-hmm. Is it different this year because he doesn't have as much guys who know his system and stuff? I mean, do they look like a different team?
Well, I think you're going to expect that anytime. They had a great group of players last year. There's no, they got two guys and three guys in the NBA off that team. Really an exceptional team, and so there were, you know, they you just like we have been. You have those cycles where just everything's really good, and now all of a sudden they're in this. There's rebuilding like we are always in, and all of a sudden there's going to be some times you guys got to fight through it. So it's I can see some consistencies. I'm frankly glad I don't see anything but seniors out there like I saw last year. At the same time, this is a talented group of freshmen now, really talented group of freshmen, and if they're all playing the way Tom wants them to play, they'll be every bit as good as any of his teams. But it takes time for all this. Guys are going to develop at different rates.
Because of the inconsistencies, is there some uncertainty that you don't know kind of what you're going to see tomorrow?
Now, you know, their inconsistency came because Miles Bridges, probably one of the best players in the country, was hurt most of the year. That's their inconsistency.
Okay.
And so when he comes back, there's going to be some inconsistencies while you try to fit him back into it. But that's what it comes down to so many times. I think when teams are evolving to become really good teams, they go through things that have to go through to be a better team. They just have to be. If you take our championship team 2 or 3 years ago, we had a terrible November. We weren't good against Duke, against Iowa State, all these things. And all of a sudden, we were like as good as you can get in January, February. We don't get to be good unless you have inconsistencies. At some point, the kids realize it gets better.
Chris,
I think you mentioned that you guys had a really bad practice one day last mm-hmm. week, and. Defensively, though, are you seeing the signs in practice that indicate what you're seeing in terms of improved defense on the floor?
We see. There was a time in practice, and you don't even see them in games, but there was a time in practice 2 days ago where John Teske, in a full court drill, dove full length, got his hand on a ball, landed on his belly, patted it. He couldn't get it, but Xavier Simpson then dove, did the same thing, and patted to somebody, and his team went on to score. Those two, there was no way they would have done that earlier in the year. And they're just this thing, it just is not magic. And it happens overnight. But I still don't see us being the Michigan shutdown unit is coming to town. That ain't happening. We're gonna have to still outscore people. and for a while and try to just continue to make up this difference of what, and I know, and I'm not sharing with all you guys, where are the issues, right? Some of them are individual, some of them are quick, athletically related, you know, some are that slow processing. Where are these issues and how we can speed up the process, speed up the quickness, be beyond, be more intuitive in our defensive, as we see a scheme or an action happen, how can we be ahead of the action instead of always reacting to it?
And then off topic a little bit, have you watched Karras a little bit in Brooklyn starting to play a little bit more?
Yeah, you know, I've been following our guys the best I can, but I mean, right now, of all those guys that have gone pro right now, you know, the four guys that were between Glenn and Nick, right, Karras right now, are really getting major time. And when you see them in their freshman year, I think we have to get used to this in the NBA as well as college basketball. What you see as a rookie, what you see as a freshman, is not what you're going to see in a couple of years. And Karras right now getting this time, and it's obviously, it's not good they're losing. It is good for him that he's getting this time. But for Nick to get this time now, right, for Glenn to get this time, Trey's in every game. He's got a great backcourt in front of him. You know, that's certainly a big deal, too. Timmy Hardaway is the evolution right now. I look at him the other day on a video, and he's like this man. He's this man. And it just seems like the other day he's got this smile in my office. So these guys are all really evolving as NBA players. I mean, guys that will be in the league for a while if they can just keep that same hard work that they showed here. But Karras, I'm really proud that he's getting, not to have, his story is different because for so long, that kid was in the training room at both places for almost 3 years. I mean, for every part of 2 years, maybe half of almost three, he's in a training room waiting and rehabbing, and it's all paying off. So just love to see him have the success. And I haven't spoken to him in a little bit, but I'm sure he's as humble as ever and feels blessed as ever.
Biddle?
Coach, so before last night's game, I think people thought that Indiana and Michigan State would be a really tough stretch for the team. Obviously, last night's game was decided pretty early. Do you think...
You thought it was over? Did you think it was over early? I don't. I hate being up like that. I hate it.
But what do you think, like, in which direction it might sway against Michigan State? Do you think it'll go back to being, like, that tight, tough, close game?
I would expect that. I would expect that. That this is... We're going. I thought they'd only lost one in a row, and I was reminded this morning they lost three in a row. So, I'm sure they're coming out. They'll be fired up. Michigan's coming to town. These are a great set of games every single year, and I'm sure it'll be a fired up atmosphere, and we're going to go in there with everything we got. At the same time, it does not define our season yet, right? Our season will be defined at the end of the year as we continue to grow because it's a. It's a long, long year, and we're in the middle of a big time. We just got to keep getting better.
I think we want to close this out. John, with the high ball screen stuff that you're doing right now, is this...
Offensively or defensively?
Offensively. Is this about as good as you've seen it, especially recently? And what else, more importantly, what else can you kind of build off of it? What extra wrinkles or residuals
can you find? Well, I think what's happened with us when we've had success is the fact that we've got a stretch five, that they don't know if he's rolling or popping. And speaking about Mo, I don't know if he's rolling or popping. Well, his teammates are trying to figure that out, and we're trying to get there. So, but that has opened the court a great deal. And so that's allowed us to do a little bit more. But Derek's seen it better. We've seen a lot, like last night, they cross-match. I call it a cross-match. They guarded their four or threes on our five so they could switch everything. So then we got a different plan for that, and we worked that plan a little bit. So it is I just can't tell you, every year we don't know what we're going to see from the other team, and we got to evolve quickly. So I think our kids, it slowed down for them a little bit about what to see. And the most encouraging play yesterday was with, they ran that cross match. We screened screened for Derek with DJ, and Derek just shot it in. He wasn't looking for it. He just went to score and shot it in. That's huge for us to do that instead of look to be just only a passer. So I don't know where it is. I don't think it's as good. I really don't think it is as good as it was when we had Nick and Karras all in it, or when we had Trey and Timmy in it, but we're working at it.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, thanks, everyone.